ਕਿੱਦਾਂ ਹਾਊਜ਼ ਐਵਰੀਵਨ ਡੂਇੰਗ ਤੁਸੀਂ ਤਿਆਰ ਹੋ ਬਿਕਾਜ਼ ਆਈ ਐਮ ਕੰਪਲੀਟਲੀ ਰੈਡੀ ਟੂ ਟਾਕ ਟੂ ਇੰਡੀਆਜ਼ ਵੁਮੈਨ ਬਾਸਕਟਬਾਲ ਕੈਪਟਨ ਆਫ ਦਾ ਇੰਡੀਆ ਟੀਮ ਰਸਪ੍ਰੀਤ ਸਿੱਧੂ ਸੋ ਲੈਟਸ ਨਾਓ ਟਾਕ ਟੂ ਰਸਪ੍ਰੀਤ ਸਿੱਧੂ ਆਲ ਦਾ ਵੇ ਫਰੋਮ ਇੰਡੀਆ
It may not mean nothing to y'all, but understand nothing was done for me. So I don't plan on stopping at all. I want it forever, mine, ever mine, ever mine. I shut this down in the mall. And selling that girl, she the one for me. And I ain't even planning to call. I want it forever, mine, ever mine, ever mine.
So with me in this very moment, I have Raspreet Sidhu, who is a captain of India's women's basketball team. Thank you, Raspreet, Sat Sri Akal, and thank you for joining me today.
Sat Sri Akal, thank you. It's a pleasure. Thank you for having me.
Thank you, Raspreet. So Raspreet, to begin, tusi please, apne career path, can you walk us through your journey? So tanu shuru to hi pata si tusi basketball player banna chahunde ha, or did this happen along the way?
So, you know, to start with, I think your genes are Punjab, they that always played a lot of big role in it, because my dad was an athlete and he was, you know, he wasn't fortunate enough to run for the country, but he's run for his state, for his college, went to the India camp. So, Hanji jeans ta jidda main dassya pehla to sige, but you know, it just went along the way. Although he never pressurized me to play or pick up any sport, but unhan nu physical fitness and, you know, to remain, to be healthy, to live a healthy lifestyle. Matlab, daddy mainu yaad hai, wo roti khana bhul sakde si, but not forgetting his walk, not forgetting his, you know, physical fitness. So I think unconsciously, mere dimag bhi just, so I used to accompany my dad, and that's where I think I built my, you know, I was inclined towards picking up any sport. So, yeah.
That's great. And shuru to interest basketball wal si ke hor vi kise sport che ta interest reha ya?
Dekho, normally ta ji India school a thano pata hi ya ki hunda agar ek bhi koi kudi ya munda, they are very good or they are very athletic, ta unhan nu sari game cho sare coaches nu chahide hunde ya. So my journey was no different. So mainu yaad hai jab main school se gi, main fifth, I was also an you know, all-rounder athlete, kyunki athletics ta jinna tuhanu pata is a mother sport for any other sport you want to pick up. You know, you name a sport and athletics is the mother sport. So main pehla athletics gayi, so my coach was so happy when I became the district champion. So uske baad main kho-kho try kita, then my football coach pulled me in. So, but you know, one fine day my PE teacher came to me and he said, Raspreet, tusi kal aana, because kal basketball the coach aa raha hai. He is an India player himself, and oh, USA rehnde, but he is born and brought up in the country. I said, wow, very good. I was in sixth grade, and you know, going into seventh grade, it was the break, that session break which was going on.
Hanji.
And I remember, Sapreet, I went for that training, and I went for a week or 2 weeks, and there was no looking back. Like, I don't recall doing any other sport. I know main bahut sare apne coaches nu, you know, narash kita, because then I sort of got glued to the game, and I think that was meant to be.
I agree.
So, yes.
Yeah, main tari videos bhi dekhi hai Instagram te. I mean, I was amazed at how good you are. I was honestly absolutely astonished ke how well you play basketball.
Thank you so much. It was thode sare da pyar aa. It's the, you know, it's silent effort of so many people, my parents, family, my coach, and right today my husband. I think if the support nahi hunda, then, you know, there would have been no Raspreet Sidhu.
Hanji.
And of course, Baba ji di kirpa, that always has to be there. But yeah, there's a lot of, I feel I'm blessed. That's it. Hanji.
That's beautiful. And overall, a journey kidda rahi hai? Because I know basketball haj India, which it's a newer sport, aap keh sakte, and even more so for women. So, kuch challenges to see jo face kitte hon on your career path?
Hanji. So basically, you know, agar main je main apni journey thode naal thodi ji share karan starting to.
Hanji.
So how a normal child is supposed to be raised in a family, irrespective of where you are, whether you're in India or you're abroad. I think all thanks to my parents, I was brought up how an ideal child should be brought up. So, mainu othe jo differences, India ch bahut sari kudiyan nu jo, you know, face karne pende hai ki pehla apni family naal lado, odha baad jaake you go and face the world. Thankfully, वो चैलेंज मेरे को बिल्कुल नहीं सीखा, बिकॉज मेरे डैडी बहुत सपोर्टिव सीखे. आई थिंक ही वेंट ऑल आउट, इफ नॉट फॉर हिम लाइक आई सेड यू नो आई वुडन्ट हैव बीन हियर टॉकिंग टू यू. बट वो तो बात, एक चीज जो बहुत ज्यादा खटक दिया एंड इट्स स्टिल यू नो अ लॉन्ग वे टू गो व्हेन इट व्हेन वी टॉक इन इंडिया अबाउट बास्केटबॉल एंड स्पेशली अबाउट वुमेन इज प्रोफेशनलिज्म. कोई भी ऐदा नहीं, मतलब रेलवे नु छड़ के नाले एक दो केरला इलेक्ट्रिसिटी बोर्ड, एक दो बैंक्स नु छड़ के कोई पीएसयू पब्लिक सेक्टर यूनिट्स ऐदा दी नहीं आगे आ रहे या नीदर प्राइवेट कंपनीज आर कमिंग फॉरवर्ड टू यू नो गिव एजुकेशन टू गिव जॉब, बिकॉज जॉब ऑप्शंस आर एक्सट्रीमली इंपॉर्टेंट. वंस यू प्लेइंग टिल जूनियर अंडर 18 लेवल यू डोंट केयर, बट वंस यू गो टू द सीनियर लेवल यू नीड दैट प्रोफेशनलिज्म, राइट? चिल्ड्रन नीड टू लुक अप टू, ओके व्हाट आर वी गोना डू व्हेन वी ग्रो अप. So that is something which I feel, which is a challenge which our country is facing in basketball till date. Of course, bahut you know improvement hui hai je mein last 10 years ya 20 saal se compare kara, it's been a lot of improvement, but it's a very slow and gradual improvement. Mm-hmm. But I'm sure a league would help, a professional league would help, private companies coming forward and you know we putting some plan will help. The only thing is initiative lena padega. But which I heard that Federation was up for a league, old Karandi Puri Koshit Sige. But Corona, you know, that sort of ended everything from tournaments. But that's not just for India, right? The world is in it together. So I am just, you know, I'm quite hopeful. Let's see. And whatever we can do, OB, you know, Sarakush Pipeline Cha, I'm also trying to give back to the society, give back to the game, give back to India. So let's see.
Excellent. And Raspreet, tada vision kiya with India and basketball. What is your vision of where will basketball be one day in India?
You know, initially when I had started playing Sapreet, so I remember ki my dad had taken me to one of his, you know, bosses. So my dad's a government servant. He was a government servant. He's retired as an income tax officer. So one fine day, I know I'm telling you a story, but I'm coming back to the question. Yes. I will do it. But, you know, he had taken me to his boss and his boss asked me, ki beta tusi ki karna bade hoke? I remember without blinking an eye, I just told him, I want to play for India. And I want to continue play for India, where a regular response of any student when they're in 9th or 10th grade or 6th or 7th grade would be, I want to be a doctor or an engineer or, you know, bahut crazy. India's bahut zyada crazy. Engineering na doctor nu chhad ke koi teeji cheez bahut cut. Log prefer kar diya. I'm sure you know, people listening and you being there, you laughing, just, you know, say that, yeah, I'm right. But, you know, that was the most pehle Sapreet aim siga ki India di jersey leni. When that was achieved, the aim was, we have to have a podium finish. You know, we want to see our team. I want to see myself and my team finishing on that gold medal podium where Sada, you know, Tiranga Chanda is going up. The world is standing and the national anthem is ringing. Jab oh goal achieve ho gaya, hun eh ya that we have to become one of the best in Asia. Then we go road to Olympics. And now, I'm sure you interviewed now thought I interview hoya. See, he is a fab player. He is the one of the best Indian origin player I've ever seen play. Why I'm mentioning him is because the 3-on-3 format, Jairich Inderveer Khelda, you know, that is a format which levels a lot of countries together. Mm-hmm. So it's not a faraway dream that India will be playing Olympics in 3-on-3. Or, you know, we are getting ready for that. Or if the right kind of training and planning goes into it, there will be one day sooner where we can represent that. So that is what I see India basketball doing in the near future, say 10 years. But planning honi hogi, execution hona hoga. You know, it's easy to say it, but when it comes to execution, when it comes to planning, it requires a lot. But like I said, I'm very optimistic. And that's what my vision will always be for our country.
Absolutely. And jada 3x3 format in basketball. So jo Inderveer na meri interview hui si, although I shared with all my audience ke format ki cheeja, because some people weren't aware how it's formatted. So Evi, India de vich, how successful are you finding this format to be?
So, you know, I've been a part of the Indian national team for the past 17 years. And now I'm the senior most member in it. And also, so I lead the 3-on-3 format for the country. So 2019 Sada last tournament Siga where we, you know, did quite well. So if I talk about scope, Sapreet, I think 3x3, the scope is way larger than regular 5x5. You know, and I'm sure we are doing our bit because, like I told you, not time cut, but it's just a level playing field. And Indians are very good shooters. So 3x3, jo bahar to shooting na bhi changi hai na, they are always successful. Because you get straight 2 points for a three, whereas you get 1 point for an inside shot, right? So I think they will, like I said, when I spoke about Olympic qualifiers, etc., I mean 3x3. And that's how, if we focus right, the focus is right, jaisi right type of training kariye na, we are not lagging behind, you know. Anything can happen once we put a mind to it. But I really feel that 3x3, the scope, even Indian basketballs, don't know munde, the kuniya, which is a lot.
Absolutely. I know. Scope, there's so much talent in India. Although Inder Bir bhi gal kar rahe si ke Punjab de vich, Tamil Nadu de vich, there's some aspiring players coming out of there. And like he had said, and like you are mentioning today, ke India de vich, there's so much talent and so much scope ke basketball can go really far.
Yes, yes, it sure can. Because like you said, you know, they powerhouses hai gaya. Two, three states have been powerhouses of producing players and, you know, trying to work for the development of the sport. But, oh yeah, you know, right time, I will just come back to planning and execution. Because I see, aaj baike 6 months di planning nahi kar se. Sanu aaj baike agle 10 saal di planning karke jaisi chaliye. You know, the results will be far, far better than what we can do a short-term planning for.
Bilkul. And jab aap present day well dekhiye, no pandemic ne sare nu affect kita, sare trade, sare sports, sare industry nu. Hum basketball is a contact sport, so eva impact kis level tak with basketball in India, how detrimental has a pandemic been towards this?
Initially tai suddenly bahut, you know, at least for us, because of the 3x3, like you were just talking about it, Sapreet, India had gotten opportunity. Sanu opportunity mili si ki asi Olympic qualifier apne kar karwaye. You know, it was scheduled to be in Bangalore in India, but it just Corona hit us. And so because we were hosts, so we were getting an opportunity to play the tournament and we were really looking forward to it. But, you know, like all of us know, it's not just us in it. Pura world is together. But only thing is, we can just hope now that once we get that opportunity again, of course, it's affected in a lot way. Now we've started to come back a little together, but kyunki camps wagera lagne shuru hue hain pichle 3-4 mahine to. But like you said, basketball was the last 18 category Indian government ne ki thi, sports sign, Sports Authority of India ne, jehde ki individual sport hai jinach koi contact nahi. They were allowed to start a little earlier. And of course, for obvious reasons, jo sport bahut highly contact sports are like basketball, the una di training kafi late shuru hui. Now, you know, that gap of 1 year is of course going to hurt the team. It's not that easy because staying away from the game, and even if you're working out, you're working out at your houses, you're not even allowed to go to the court because the country was completely in lockdown. Mm-hmm. But now we were just about to get together, but you know, it's been a little depressing ki phir India ch ek do jagah ch lockdown hun lag gaya, jisda ki tuhanu pata hi hoga. But again, Sapreet, you know, we just hopefully everything comes back on track. But like I said, assi sare ede ch ikatthe ha, it's not just assi kalle nahi ha.
I 100% agree with that. And je apa government di support di gal kariye, so overall, how supportive has the government been, whether that's resources they're providing, javasi overall supporting the basketball team? So government di kis level tak tusi involvement dekhde ya?
See, ki hunda Sapreet, India, chino, I'll just give you a little background. So Sports Authority of India is in charge of, you know, upliftment and development of all the sports the country plays, right? And especially of the ones where jaake India represent karde asi bahar jaake, where we represent the global stage. So sai they under sari federations on the, which is Basketball Federation of India, say Football Federation of India, so Badminton Federation, all these sports federations are there, which comes under Sports Authority of India. E dono units milke, you know, that's when they plan, they execute, they develop, and there's a lot of brainstorming which goes on. So right now, Indian government has come up with Khelo India. I don't know if you're aware of it, but Khelo India initiative is an other initiative which will help the grassroots level. You know, unhone initiative yehi kiya, which is very right according to me, that you pick up talent young. You pick up very young talent, you support them into the journey, and you know, let's not wait ki koi apne ek mukam te pahunch jave, o to baad assi oh player nu support kariye. You know, just to give that opportunity, I think this Khelo India will be a huge asset to sports in India, not just basketball, but to all other sports, where a jo platform sigha, you know, where you have to struggle on your own and reach at a particular level to get notice and to get support from the country. But they've just bridged that gap. Ki je nanu dekha ki talent, young talent nu select karke, nurture karke, then they are going to have a, you know, it's a 10-20 year planning. And that's exactly what I was speaking about a bit back. So I think all these projects are hegeya. Baki thoda se private companies ye thoda agge aayi hai, kyunki na the CSR initiative bhi hunda, unta sports ad ho gaya ode. So I think we'll be much faster in the process. But yes, government is doing what they can best to ensure that, you know, country reaches. I'll just tell you a little bit about Olympic Gold Quest. So a committee of Olympic Gold Quest, wo athletes ne support kar diya jo they feel will, you know, bring laurels to the country in Olympics. So that in itself is a great initiative, because then they take single-handedly care of that athlete. The only thing that athlete's supposed to do is just train. Rest, everything is taken care of. So I think all these initiatives will definitely get us more noticed, and you know, we definitely will get more medals for India.
Definitely. That's amazing. Good to know. Okay. There is very good support coming from the government as well there. They, for us, jede apa bar Western countries de vich baithe ha, how can we support jede tusi sare India de vich, all your efforts you're putting into basketball, how can we support you?
So basically, you know, it's a federation level te jo, I'm not too sure that, of course, there can be contacts and there can be meetings if someone is interested to speak to the secretary and the president of the federation. But always, if that's not the route anyone wants to take, because it's a personal choice, right? There are bade sare NGOs and there are lots of, you know, non-government bodies which are trying to help promote basketball. So if you want, I can, you know, of course, get you connected and get all our people connected to them. And then they can definitely, because NGOs jo normally kar rahe hai, oh, base root level, you know, they are picking up kids who are 6 years old, 7 years, and underprivileged ones. Mm-hmm. You know, from the two tier cities where sare nu opportunity jinanu nahi mili ya khelndi, othe ja ke, even I'm associated with an NGO where I go and dedicate a day in a week, every, so 4 times a month I go there definitely to, and there's 60 kids coming there, 30 boys, 30 girls. The initiative is, like I said, just to give back. So ode cho 2-3-4 khiladi bhi bade hoke je India layi khele ho, you know, they settle somewhere, I think that will be a huge win. So yeah,
definitely. And Raspreet, could you give any encouraging words, jo advice unna vaste jo shayad they're aspiring to become basketball players, or for those young female audience that look at you as a role model?
Yes, this is actually my favorite part, and you know, just to be in a position to talk to so many of young minds, and you know, just try and you know, hit a chord somewhere. I just feel super blessed. So my advice ji hamesha ehi rehndi hai ki dream big, you know, dream big, envision yourself living that dream every single day. So dreams will take you, you know, they know their way, but do not let anyone tell you that you cannot do something because of your gender or because of your class or because where you stay. You know, if you believe in yourself with the right amount of belief, and hard work, there's no substitute to it, but dreaming big and you just imagining yourself there, you can do wonders. You know, my favorite quote right now, you know, I always tell these young people, the little ones which I meet, that how can even sky be the limit for you when there are footprints on the moon? Aapa apni limit aap set. Aapa apni limit aap set kar de. It's on us where we want to take it to. So go far beyond your even imagination. So yes, dream big, dream on, and believe in yourself, believe in your hard work, and baki rab rakha.
Thank you, Raspreet. Thank you so much for sharing all your thoughts and your beautiful encouragement. It's absolutely a pleasure to be speaking to you today.
Thank you so much, Sapreet. I think pleasure is all mine. It is so good to connect to our people, even overseas, and you being the medium of it. Thank you so much for having me.
Thank you. And I want to wish you the best of luck with everything.
Thank you so much. Sat Sri Akal.
Sat Sri Akal. Sat Sri Akal.
करिए नस नस मेरी खोले हाय कुछ करिए कुछ करिए कुछ करिए बस बस बड़ा बोले अब कुछ करिए ओ कोई तो चल जिद फड़िए तू बेतरिए या मरिए हाय कोई तो चल जिद फड़िए तू बेतरिए या मरिए चकले गलियों में राशन की फलियों में बैलों में बीजों में ईदों में दीजों में रेतों के दानों में फिल्मों के गानों में सड़कों के गड्ढों में बातों के अड्डों में भूखा रोज भर ले दस बारह बार कर ले रहना न यार पीछे कितना भी कोई खींचे तस है ना मस है जी जिद है तो जिद है जी किसना यूं ही किसना यूं ही किसना यूं ही पत्थरिए कोई तो चल जिद फड़िए तू बेतरिए या मरिए हाय कोई तो चल जिद फड़िए तू बेतरिए या मरिए चकले खतर में छींटे में ढूंढो तो मिल जाओगे तब ताबो ही तो में रंग ऐसा आज बिखरे और खुल के आज बिखरे मन जाए ऐसी होली रग रग मचल के बोली तस है ना मस है जी जिद है तो जिद है जी किसना यूं ही किसना यूं ही किसना यूं ही पत्थर है कोई तो चल जिद फड़िए तू बेतरिए या मरिए हाय कोई तो चल जिद फड़िए तू बेतरिए या मरिए चकले